Hey there everyone, this is Seb bringing you a new review here on godgame.com. It's almost Halloween time and Konami just released their second game using the Saw license. The first one wasn't too great and it was a missed chance. But did Konami learn from their mistakes? Can this one make us cower under the sheets? Or is it justified to rip this new attempt to pieces? Success or failure, Konami, you've made your choice. As most of you probably know, the Saw movies are all about gruesome death traps out of which the victims need to escape. If guts and gore are your thing, then you should feel right at home with the series. Just like in the first game, it is up to you to get to the end of the gauntlet that Jigsaw has set up for his guests. This time you play as Michael Tapp, the son of the protagonist of the first movie and game. I'm not going to spend more time on the story, as in all honesty, it's pretty stupid, confusing and non-logical. All that you need to know is that you're a new test subject and you want out of there, preferably without getting your head blown off. The game is a third-person action-adventure, which offers a lot of puzzles for you to solve and hazards to avoid. The game kinda feels like it's made in the style of Resident Evil 4 and 5, but don't be fooled by this. You see, there is actually very little direct interaction in the game. Almost everything you do is done with either a minigame or a quick time event. This is a bit of a shame, as you don't feel in direct control and as such it pulls you right out of the experience. At first things may seem a bit tense, but you'll soon learn that there is very little that can directly hurt you while you're walking around. There are some environmental hazards, and in a few sections you need to avoid certain enemies that either charge or shoot at you. These sections feel very tedious and the game just isn't made for this. In the shooting parts you just run from cover to cover while the shooter is reloading, and when you get closer they'll eventually run away, which looks just as ridiculous as it sounds. When trying to avoid enemies that are after your blood, it's often very hard to get out of the way in time. The controls are just too sluggish for this. One chase scene in particular was very annoying. If you accidentally turn into a dead end in that part, the attacker will often block your way back and keeps mauling at you while you can do absolutely nothing about it. Why don't you hit him, you might ask? Well, because you can't. It's not in the script, you see. The first game may have offered awful combat controls, but believe it or not, they actually managed to make them even worse. Or to be more exact, they outright removed them. You can't directly control your hits. Every opponent you meet has you enter a quick time event to settle things. Depending on the weapon you're holding, these might differ a bit. But as long as you're not supposed to fight anyone, you're just wearing your weaponry as decoration. These weapons are also pretty useless, by the way, as you can only use them once. It just makes no sense at all that you break a baseball bat, or worse a steel pipe, from bashing in one single head. They also offer no real advantage, as you can just as well kill enemies with your bare hands. I mean, it's not like these quick time events are that hard. And you will see them so much during this game. Tripwire? Better press the button in time to jump over it. Floor collapsing? Don't bother running further, just wait for the prompt. This game just shows how too many quick time events can make your game very boring. It also doesn't help that you see the same traps and events play over and over again. Especially the booby trap doors, they only have two variations in that and it just gets redundant really fast. Speaking of things that are redundant, the puzzles you need to do to unlock doors, disarm traps and do other things keep on repeating a lot too. Sure, some of the puzzles are pretty fun at first, I especially enjoyed the lockpicking minigame actually, I thought that was a pretty cool idea at first. But after having to do the same thing for the umpteenth time, it gets very annoying. Sometimes the same puzzle is just 5 minutes further into the game. Also, the game does a piss poor job of telling you the objective of the puzzles. Since there are pretty strict time limits in most cases, this causes you to fail the first time in almost all new events you encounter. Seriously, sometimes the game literally states the objective as disarm the trap, which isn't all that helpful, game. Luckily, the puzzles never get overly hard and most gamers should be able to blaze through the game pretty quickly. So I guess keeping things vague is sort of helpful, otherwise you might miss some of the death scenes. To be honest though, most aren't that impressive really. For an M-rated game, they keep things pretty mild and I think they could have put more effort into those deaths. I mean, come on, that's what the series is all about, right? Now, part of the disappointing deaths probably has to do with the visuals of the game. The game uses the Unreal 3 engine and it's just starting to show its age, I guess. Especially the animations are very stiff. Blood effects are also very disappointing, something that you really expect to be better in a game like this. The whole game is also very dark, a bit too dark if you ask me. But the darkness does give the game some atmosphere at least. The sounds help too. If there is one thing the game really does well, it is that it sets a very creepy atmosphere with its many background sounds, and the music also complements the on-screen action very well. The voice work isn't the greatest, however. Many of the actors just sound uninterested. Not that I can really blame them though, as the script is just bad. Basically, everyone you save says fuck you and walks off to backstab you later on in some way. But really, who is interested in the story of the Saw universe anyway? It's one entangled mess that they try to piece together with each new sequel, and is made out to be much more complex than it really is. However, if you are a real nut for all that, then the game offers a nice amount of collectibles in the form of audio tapes and logs that give more background story. Real nice fan service, and it helps the replayability too. You know, for if you feel like playing the same minigames another 30 plus times. Speaking about replayability, normally I'd rather not talk about the ending in reviews out of fear of spoilers, but I just got to get this off my chest. You see, the game pulls a real dick move on you when it comes to the ending. There are two possible endings, and one choice all the way at the beginning of the game determines which one you get. What bugs me the most about this is that it's not obvious that there is a choice at all at the time, and that the second option goes against any gaming conventions. Long story short, when I got the ending that I got, I felt very cheated out of my time spent with the main character of the game. And seeing as how tedious and repetitive the game is, I don't feel like playing it all over again. Now, there might be people who like this sort of teasing from developers, but personally it pissed me off, and I was not satisfied at all when I finished the game. I wanted to like this game. I mean, the Saw movies are a bit of a guilty pleasure of mine, although I do believe they should have ended it with the third one. In the end though, I can only recommend it to big fans of the movies, or those who really enjoy QuickTime events a lot. For everyone else, this is a low rental or very cheap budget bin pickup at best. This game won't scare you, unless you are horrified by its many game design flaws. Well guys, that's it for me. I hope you enjoyed the review, even though it wasn't too favorable this time. Let me know what you think and what games you are playing this Halloween. Until next time everyone, take care.